Hello friends, this is Lopa Banerjee from Texas, USA, and at the start of the new year 2022, this is a very special poetry video which I would be presenting in front of you all. So in this video, I would be giving a reading from a very special book written by a very special person, Nandini Sahu from India, and the book's name is Sita, a poem. So this entire book is a journey and a long poem in various different cantos or sections in which the poet has divided the poetic narratives, and all the poems talk about the narrative of Sita, the journey of Sita, Ramayana unfolded as a memoir of Sita. So to give you a brief bio of Nandini Sahu, Nandini is presently a professor of English at the School of Humanities and director, School of Foreign Languages, Indira Gandhi National Open University, IGNO, New Delhi, where she has designed academic programs on folklore and culture studies, children's literature, American literature. Broadly, her research interests span across Indian literature, new literature, folklore, culture studies, American literature, children's literature, and critical theory. Apart from being an academic, Nandini is also a very prolific poet, and she is chief editor, founder editor of the Interdisciplinary Journal of Literature and Language, IJLL, and Panorama Literature, PL, both being biannual peer-reviewed journals in English. So, given her erudition and her academic background, it is quite natural that the poems reflect not only her creative persona, but also her spirit as a very erudite woman of substance. So I would be taking the privilege of reading out parts of her preface from the book and then go to the reading of a poem eventually. In the preface, she says, "It is an accepted fact that the story of Sita comes to us with an entirely captivating contemporaneity. Since the last 2,500 years, the story has been articulated in innumerable ways in the diverse tongues of India. But in these interpretations, not only are the besieged historical accounts juxtaposed with a decipherable degree of magnetism that would make an interesting neo-historicist study, authors across the spectrum of time have also endeavored predictive elements of their own periodicity into the incarnate history of the ever-renewable legend of Ram Sita." So now I would like to read out from Canto 2. As I said, the entire book is divided into a number of cantos till Canto 25, which depicts Sita's journey in multifaceted forms and avatars. So my narration from my humble rendition from Canto 2. "I am Sita, Janaka Nandini Janaki, the doting daughter of my father, King Janaka. I am born in a furrow from Mother Earth in the sanctified sacrificial grounds. I am utterly and unquestioningly in love. I am the resolute, acquiescent, enthralling wife of Lord Rama. I am here to keep the reserve of the prevalent onuses of a patriarchal universe. Sitaya Charitam Mahat. This tiara of a reverberant and talismanic phrase they have put as my crown. My three sisters, Urmila, Mandavi, and Shrutakirti, married to Rama's brothers Lakshmana, Bharata, and Shatrughna. May I call this sisterhood? Their destinies are as complex as mine, but half as eventful. I am entwined by many a woman of substance, Anasua, sage Atri's wife, and then my concords with the legendary Gargi, Maitreyi, Katyayani, Arundhati, Lopamudra, Ahalya. Then the Rakshasa and Vanara queens, Mandodari and Tara. It's a women's world, female bonding, the tales of incredible exoneration and extraction. My story is empirical. You may revolutionize or rationalize its ingredients. Ravana, my abductor, was 10-headed. Hanuman, my devotee, could wax or wane in size. Kumbhakarna, gargantuan demon in a prolonged slumber. Rama built a bridge over the sea to reach me. Don't ask, is it possible? Don't question the uncanny exploits. Don't raise eyebrows. What is momentous in my story is the Sita-ness of Sita, the Pativrata, the holy, fair and chaste woman, and the force and grace that emanates from my character with equivalent rationalization in spite of the seeming metamorphosis. I have seen many lives in one life. Necromancy, the blackest of all the black arts, played a trick in my epic action. The magic deer, the Maya Sita, the demons, the snake darts. But necromancy has never been the ultimate factor in my hurt, indignant fate. It is, rather, the love and the chastisement which have time and again pushed me to square one. In my epic recital, the essential apprehension is to fathom Rama, my human and humane husband, my lord. The rest add up to the elements of the invisible wrenches of prudence and to the dynamics of my free will. Yes, I am Sita, the willingly exiled woman. There is no archaism with a reckoning. And the very last part of Canto 2, it's phenomenal in its depth of expressions. I designate my torment and wield my sovereignty by retiring from Rama after he asks me to take a second test of fire. But I have completed the full cycle of my professed duties of daughterhood, wifehood, and motherhood, beyond patriarchal manipulations and domestic blues. My heart-rending history momentously links the Rama-Ravana stories. In a hypothesis, I have the obligation to repeat this immense and magnificent record, hence this poem. What a phenomenal epic rendition, epic poem, rephrasing an epic with erudition and mastery over words. I salute the spirit of Nandini Sahu, the poet, in depicting the spirit of Sita through the presentation of the character of Sita as a protagonist in this book, Sita, a Poem, which is published by the Poetry Society of India. And I hope you liked my humble rendition of Canto 2, the poem of this phenomenal book, which is again named Sita, a Poem by Nandini Sahu. Thank you once again for listening, and I hope you liked my humble presentation.